What's up, everybody? It's your boy DJ Nama, the one they call Mr. Showtime of SCP Radio. Woo! And ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you guys a family of love, a family of pride, a family of nothing but education in the arts of music that has to do with Tejano, Conjunto, Jazz, y mucho más. And if you know what I'm talking about, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna hook you up right now. Epi and friends and his wonderful mother right here.
Thank you.
It don't get no better than that.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate that.
Hey, bro. Today you put on a slamming show with your mom. And let me be the first to say, or if I'm not the first to say, I want to be the first to say, tonight you made a statement. Epi and friends is in the house. You rocked the house. And brother, you brought that conjunto out. Like, it's my stage.
Thank you, man. Well, you know, I love it, man. To start off, I love it so much, man. I love breathing it. I couldn't wait to get on stage. I was nervous. Just being out here just makes me nervous. But when I'm on stage, I feel another world, man. Like I just, every time I get on, man, it's over for everybody. Everything in the, you know, all my problems, everything is gone, you know, so it's like I needed to release a lot of emotion and all that good stuff out of me, man, and it just comes out of me, man. I thank God for that, bro. I mean, I'm very blessed, you know, to have a mom and a dad that influenced me when I was a little boy, man.
So,
you know,
that's how all this started.
I grew up in the harmony, my man.
Es que como dice el dicho, más antes decía que el que nace para tamales del cielo le caen las hojas. O sea, nosotros, este no nació para tamales, del cielo le cayeron las notas, la música, que son muy diferentes.
So, when Epi was real chiquito, did you have to push him to practice?
No, era un gorro de mariachi.
I was a pet, man. You couldn't take me off the bed or anything.
No,
man.
Es que si la escucharía Jaiba, estaba en la mesa. Muchacho. Y luego yo nunca aspiré que él fuera músico, porque la carrera de los músicos es mucho, muy sufrida, porque no comes a tiempo, no llegas a tiempo, te desvelas demasiado. Tenemos en todo, hay crítica buena, crítica mala, y pues te ponen nervioso. Y nerviosa, porque yo estaba muy sentadita, mientras que todos sentados además estaban cantando, y yo estaba toda, ni una gota de sudor. Ya no, me subía de arriba y que comienzo yo. Y luego viendo toda la gente, pero a mí me da, puedo decir que me siento bien bendecida, porque yo ya había dejado la carrera de la música.
Wow.
Y cuando él comenzó, que él dijo que él iba a comenzar a hacer su grupo y a... La madre dijo, quiero que me ayudes a cantar, muchacho. Le dije, yo tengo años de no subirme arriba. Ya, pues,
¿Cómo qué tantos, mamá? ¿Cómo qué tantos?
Sí, ¿cuántos?
Son años.
Voy a decir que del 85.
Chihuahua. I was still a baby.
Del 85, porque... Es, pero yo, a pesar de que, ¿cómo te diré? Me gusta mucho la música desde que estaba chica. Esa última canción que le dije a Fluffy que la iba a traer para acá para que la pusieran en el radio, La Una de Pesares, yo la cantaba cuando tenía 11 años la canción esa.
11 años.
Y me encantaba la cancioncita esa, y tenía a mi papá un hermano que donde quiera me vivía él viendo dónde andaba yo, porque cuando anduviera en la labor o anduviera en el filo o lo que sea, él todo el tiempo me pescaba cantando, y yo era bien vergonzosa. Y un día estaba con la hija de él, y ella me estaba llenando los brazos de esta, ¿cómo le dicen?, de leña, porque tenían los estufales de leña.
Sí.
Y yo cante. Luego cuando volteé, ahí estaba mi tío, y no, hombre, se me cayó la leña, y él le decía a mi papá, oye, mucho, Cruz va a ser una cantante, y decía mi papá, no, hombre, no. Y él fue el único, cuando yo tenía 11 años, que él me inspiró. Y ahora ya no tengo a mi tío, pero ahora que canto esa canción, no la canto y se me figura que él me está escuchando.
Yeah.
Él me está escuchando.
So that song I learned it at school. I didn't know that was one of the first songs that she sang and stuff.
Wow.
Like that. And I go, Mom, we're going to record La Una de Pesares.
So when you started...
So Mico, I haven't sang that song since I was 12 years old. Did you know that was the very first song I've ever sung in my life? boom, that's magic, bro. Right? Like, wow, magic, brother.
So how do you feel when
well, I didn't even want to
Epi on stage?
De principio, quiero, lo voy a decir en público. Cuando yo comencé a cantar con mi hijo, había veces que me volteaba y I had flashbacks porque mi hijo se parece bastante a su padre. En rato lo miraba y, ay, caray, estoy cantando con el difunto, dice yo. Y porque se parece mucho él a su papá. No puedo decir que
so,
se
so by you playing the bongo, bro, who taught you these instruments or did you take it upon yourself to learn on your own?
Well, you know, my mom and dad would give a lot, you know, so.
Because the reason I ask you, brother, and I'm sorry for this story,
cool. School,
but I got a secret to share with you.
Wow.
I played guitar with Mariachi Mecca
awesome.
For 23 years.
Awesome.
And I still play every now and then with my brothers and sisters.
Y no se te olvida, no se te olvida. Porque
and I saw you play today, brother, when you play your bajo, you're not playing just the basic chords. I see that you have skills and there's jazz mixed in with a little bit more notes, minors, majors, and a little bit off. But you put them together and you just, man, brother, you make that bottle just scream.
You know?
And if they had a Santana Conjunto, I think I would call you Santana.
Santana Conjunto. Thank you, man. It's just a wonderful collection of music that I've heard throughout my whole life, man. You know, I love jazz and I love rhythms and stuff like that. Of course, I've been a drummer. That's my very first love. I've been playing drums with my mom and dad. That's how I started.
So from there, I grabbed the
From there, I grabbed the bajo.
Era el tamborero de nosotros, pero en aquel tiempo yo no le pagaba.
No, tú tenías la casa, comida.
See, no, they would pay me, dude. I'd get $5 a gig.
Hey, $5 was a lot
dude,
of money.
I had $85 saved up one time. I was like, from a lot of gigs. Por eso decía 5, carnal. $85 traigo a los salvados, bato.
That's what you did. Lucky number.
$5.
Played on the lottery.
Yeah, man. So no, man. All these influences, man. They came, you know, through the years, man. Me growing with my parents, all the musicians that my mom and dad went through, I got influenced by them, you know. And that's how I learned how to play the bajo. Y prendí las mañas de todos los bajistas que tuvo mi papá y mi mamá bajistas. Es la neta, bro.
Todos
los bajistas
dicen, no, pues, mira. Yo estaba escuchando el Little Joe Bravo, por eso me entró. But you let your mom, bro. And a lot of times in life, a lot of Chicanos, Mexicanos, lo que sea, they don't have a father or a mom or something goes wrong. But you've had the influence of them to give you something to say, mijo, I'll support you. Vámonos. That's what you want to do. Lo hacemos.
Yeah, it was in me
that since. And tonight that you sit on stage with him. That's beautiful. I would love to do something like that. That is that's priceless.
Yo le doy gracias a Dios porque todavía a mi edad, le doy gracias a Dios porque todavía gracias a Dios me presta la voz. Y como te digo, yo le doy muchas gracias a todos los locutores, no porque estén presentes, a todos les doy las gracias porque sin el público y sin los locutores no le hace qué tan buen cantante seas o qué tan buen músico eres. Si no tienes el respaldo del público y de los locutores, no llegamos a nada. Mis respetos, y lo digo de corazón, mi respeto a todo el público y a todos los locutores, porque ellos en otras maneras, they'll make you or they'll break you, una de dos.
All the time.
¿Me entiendes? Y yo le doy gracias porque, como te digo, yo cuando vine para acá con Leo, y no estoy porque esté presente, yo soy bien claridosa, yo me sentí como en mi casa, me hicieron que me sintiera como en mi casa, y sí, yo estaba sentada ahí, quiero que sepas que, oh God, estaba toda nerviosa, no, al último, y se habla, y no se ponga nerviosa, usted haga de cuenta que está platicando, y ya le agarré una confianza, y me sentí como en casa, y después cuando yo le doy de a él, le dije, Black Bay, y agarré una canción, le dije, pero no la voy a hacer release hasta que no vaya para aquí usted, porque ahí soy Epi, release la canción de ella, porque voy a llorar, ahora yo voy a hacer. Yo en la noche, I don't know why, déjame hablarle a Epi, a Fluffy, ¿me da permiso de cantar la canción?
Oh, man.
No, you
have to ask. She called you just to ask you.
The coolness of that boss.
No, no, deja tú, ya me estaba. Ya me estaba dando coraje con él porque estaba yo desde acá, allá de que ni le hacía yo. Y la puta me miró, solo que me fui por la apoyada por el stage. Y luego le digo, y luego se queda viendo por todos lados. Digo, tú, hombre. Y luego, ¿qué pasó, Luis Martín? Digo, ves, ¿me das permiso de cantar la canción? Y yo sé que todavía no la pones en el aire. Oh, sí, 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 está bueno.
That was perfect, man. That was just right.
And you know, the fact that you guys played tonight with your mother on there and releasing what you released, you guys were entered into the Honolulu's Hall of Fame.
Yeah,
la cosa, fíjate que para mí, hombre, yo quiero que sepas que cuando me dijeron eso, yo lloré, lloré no de sentimiento, lloré de gusto, porque dije, mira, lo que no hice de joven, ahora estoy haciendo de vejestorio, ahora de vieja,
you
know? ¿Me entiendes?
She deserved it a long time ago, and it was just the right time to do it. And like a big test. She passed, you know, with flying colors. And they gave it to her and my dad also, que está en el cielo. And I decided to give that one to my only sister, Margie. Margie, I love you, mama. And, you know, and I gave it to my sister, you know, just so she could have something, a nice musical momentum of my father, you know.
That's kind of cool.
Daddy's
grown,
you know.
Mama's boys.
Mama's boy, daddy's grown, you know. And we're only two, también, carnal.
Wow, just two.
They were a duet back in the day, man. So it was really hard for them, man, to start a family and stuff. So mom only had my sister, and then 5 years later, she had me. Wow. When she was 21, she had me. So.
Pero cuando yo tuve a mi hija, pues me casé bien joven. I never seen, I was 16. My daughter and I are only 16 years apart.
So they started singing, and they did an album in the 70s, and the rest is beautiful history, man.
Yeah, you know? I can understand. I can
and
imagine.
And then from there, bro, I mean, we also picked up from a bunch of great friends, man, such as Rubén Vela, Arturo Niño, Gilberto Pérez, you know, Wally González, all these wonderful, wonderful friends of my mom and dad, Agapito Zuniga, you know, all these old cats, man, that you don't even see, man, los dos Gilbertos también, carnal. I mean, Narciso Martínez, carnal, que en paz descanse, también era tío de mi papá.
So let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Correct me if I'm wrong, okay? Is tonight the very first night of Epi and Friends?
Here at Tumbleweeds, yes, sir, it is, man. So, Houston, actually, with my mom having a big gig, yeah, man, I could call it the very first time here in Houston, Texas, man. Making a nice impact and all.
Brother, you made a statement hard tonight, and let me tell you, we had everything broadcasting live, the video was rolling. Brother, you're on fire. Do you realize or do you even know how many people are watching you tonight when you're on stage?
I don't know.
Social
man.
Media is big. Long time ago, they used to say, this, we got FM radio, this.
I remember that back in the day.
Hey, respect to all y'all. Pero ya se acabaron. The time is up.
Yeah.
Pero la radio no sirve bien ni bien.
And right now, we're using social media to the advantages. SCP Radio does one of the only things that no other internet radio station does, and that's put it on TV, and we blast it on every social media website that is.
That's awesome.
The views are over 95,000
viewers we saw.
Wow.
And that's from liking, from sharing, inviting people to check it out. Even people that have not seen you perform in person, but they're watching the video, bro. And the fact that you did it with your mother, she just called herself an angel. You're right. Because without the man upstairs, it wouldn't happen.
Yo le doy gracias a Dios, y no me canso de dar gracias a Dios. Sin Dios, primeramente Dios y el público, le doy gracias a los dos, al público, no. Primeramente Dios. De que le doy gracias a Dios porque todavía tengo la voz y le pido a Dios que me la siga prestando. Porque una cosa sí me gusta cantar y me gusta sentir la canción. sentir la canción, porque hay mucha gente que yo he visto cantantes que no le ponen el sentimiento, lo que... Y yo siento que yo estoy cantando la canción y me estoy imaginando como esa canción de Pueblo Viejo, it means a lot for me. Because I can remember my grandfather one time that I was singing it allá en México, a él en una boda que fue cantar yo y mi esposo, y él estaba paradito en la esquina y en mi acordeón que estaba llorando.
You know, when I was just a little baby, my mother used to party hard. She used to go to this place called the Pan American here in Houston. And it was big to everybody. It was a ballroom where you could go and you could see Carlos Guzman, Chelo Silva.
Oh yeah.
You could see
the godfather of the Tejano music, one of the first, Isidro Lopez. Sonny Osuna. All of them were in there. And that's what I was listening to in my mom's studio. But my mom never had an idea of what I was going to do, if I was going to be into that type of music. I came from a Chicano family. My grandfather was from San Antonio. My grandmother was from Gonzales, Texas. Well, when I got to a small little school, they had mariachi music. I saw the guitar. I thought it looked cool, so I wanted to play.
I like it too.
So when I played the guitar, I broke all the strings. As you know, they said, ¿sabes qué, Chicano? No, we're going to give you something else. That's something you won't break. I mean, they gave me guitar. I started learning mariachi songs, Son de la Negra, Madrugada, and then he made me learn a song that to this day I cannot forget it. It's still in my head, and it's called Mochila Azul. ¿Qué te pasa, chiquillo?
Oh, yeah, Mochila Azul.
Yes,
Mochila Azul. I sang it too when I was in the second grade. En la casa.
That was one of the first songs I sang when I was in the second grade, bro.
Wow. That's one of my first songs, bro.
Can I platicate lo que pasó ahí en Jesse's Place de Elsa?
Oh, mom, come on, we don't have to go there.
Yes, we do. We
don't have to go there.
Que él cantó esa canción.
She has to go there.
La canción, esa canción. Y mi suegra estaba tan emocionada, mi suegra de vida, él tenía 6, 7 años, cantar la Mochila Azul. Oye, ya cuando acabó comenzó a llorar, él le dice, why are you crying?
Mamá, abuelita, pues comenzó a llorar y llorar porque no le gustó como canté yo.
You don't like it.
Nada, mi suegra estaba llorando de gusto porque ni este creía que estaba llorando mi suegra. Que
she didn't like it.
Abuelita está llorando porque no le gustó la canción, mamá.
But you're trying.
This is embarrassing, dude.
No, bro, those are the good times.
I'm turning all red.
We're gonna have to give him another shout, Cazadores. Está llorando. I want to say a big thank you to you guys for allowing us to have this interview.
It won't be the last one, man. We're gonna do another one.
And brother, I mean it. You made a statement tonight. And by the way you did it with your mother on stage, brother, God is with you.
Thank you, bro. Thank you so much, man.
And let me be the first one to say out loud, welcome to Houston, Texas.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it, man. You got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're tuned in with SCP Radio. I'm your boy, DJ Nando, Mr. Showtime. And it don't get no better than this, because it's nothing but Showtime with SCP Radio live in the mix.
Gracias, respetable público. Quiero mucho que Dios nos bendiga a todos.